Good morning, Mario, and good morning, Switch fans. Happy Friday, happy another day in a random location with a water bottle because my mug stash is being shipped over to my permanent residence. We'll get there one day, but look, I gotta keep my head high because we have an awesome show to do for all of you. So what's going on, everybody? It's Zach from SwitchForce. I'm excited to be here because there are some secret Nintendo Switch games that were not shown off at Indie World or any Direct and are still coming soon. Can't wait to tell you about that one. Plus, Nintendo, listen to me. They're bringing more demos to the Switch after I requested more demos. All right, and they're doing more for Nintendo Switch Online. They really are listening and I'm impressed, all right? We have a few other things to talk about as well, including a massive end of the year sale, but let's dive straight in to the goodies. Make sure to hit that like button if you enjoy these videos and let me know your take on today's topics in the comments down below. Now, if you wanna do a little favor for your body, my cool GMM 200 limited edition merch is still available in these swanky, lovely colors. It's got the new insignia, which says, make every morning a good morning, helping to spread our positive message. And there's a bunch of varieties, including a super sexy new mug with original Good Morning Mario art. I love that one. I cannot wait to have it and hold it and drink my tea from it. But if you wanna do a favor for your Switch, gotta go with the Lexar Play Card. Big thanks to my friends over at Lexar. They make the best, fastest, most reliable, most secure memory card for Nintendo Switch, all the way up to 1 terabyte in size. That is gonna store every Switch game you could possibly imagine. So make sure to click the link in the description down below. Every time you do, it helps support the channel and it helps support your Switch. Let's begin with a merry-go-round of quick but important stories. All right, Nintendo kicked off their festive sale over on the eShop in Europe for now. It just began right now, and it goes until December 29th. This features over 1,000 games at some pretty delicious discounts. Now, I'd say it's not as good of a sale as Black Friday, but that makes sense. This one, though, wrapping up your year, and if you get any gift cards or any sort of eShop credit for the holidays, a great chance to spend before 2021 is up. It looks to be a very eclectic list. Of course, there's over 1,000 games. You're gonna find plenty of franchises and genres. Overcooked 2, Mario plus Rabbids Kingdom Battle, Dragon Ball FighterZ, Jackbox Party Pack, Ni No Kuni, Resident Evil, Bioshock, Little Nightmares, Fast RMX. I kind of love reading this because it just goes to show like how diverse Nintendo's arsenal is. It's amazing. Hopefully this sale comes stateside soon. I'll definitely let you know. We also have a demo for Dragon Ball Z Kakarot, which is the big Goku simulator, Be Goku. And in fact, in Bandai Namco's tweet, they said like, do you want to experience life in the world of Dragon Ball Z? Well, now you can with a free demo. And I love that they're doing more demos. I kind of think every game should have a demo, even if it's a limited time demo, you know, like, hey, play for 15 minutes. Great chance to check it out. And that kind of helps sort of solve that problem we talked about with, you know, refunds on games. If there's a demo, then it's like, hey, well, you can try it out for free. So even if Switch is a bit stingy on how they handle refunds and redos, well, at least you have a chance to test it out. Let me know in the comments down below if you're gonna pick anything up from this sale on the eShop or if you're gonna try out Kakarot in its new demo form. This is a strange one here. All right, we look to Nintendo and the online service and we say, hey, we'd love some more modern stuff, right? Everybody dreams of GameCube, right? That's what we really wanna see on this system. That's where we'd like Nintendo to go, Game Boy Advance. Well, there's some progress being made in the opposite direction. A very strange tweet came from Thalamus Digital, a retro-focused indie developer and publisher, and here's what they posted. You asked for C64 games on the Nintendo Switch. We listened. Stay tuned. #2022. Now, of course, this is not directly affiliated with the big end themselves, but apparently we asked for Commodore 64 games on Nintendo Switch. Like, this is taking it way back to the 80s. And again, like, great to have catalogs on the system for all sorts of retro flair, but I think we wanna go forward. Again, this is not Nintendo adding these to Nintendo Switch Online. We'll get to that in a moment. If you are a fan of Commodore 64, gosh, you gotta be older than me, because I didn't even play Commodore 64, okay? They've got a lot of very old arcade titles, like Bubble Bobble, Turrican, Whizball, and Mayhem in Monster Land. So if you're jonesing for any of these, apparently 2022 is your year. Let me know if you've played Commodore 64 or heard of Commodore 64 in the comments down below. Now then, let's get to something really exciting that I can really get behind drinking my tea water. Super sleuths of the internet spotted something on the ESRB. And you know the ratings board is where we find a lot of peculiar upcoming Switch details, right? Leaks happen there all the time across the world. But this one comes from the US ESRB and it's for a game that I actually find to be very, very fun. It's called Remnant from the Ashes. And it was rated recently for Nintendo Switch. In fact, right before the Indie World presentation, so some fans thought it would pop up at Nintendo's December showcase. It did not, but it should show up pretty soon. And if you're not familiar, Remnant is basically Dark Souls with guns. Now this is a really good mix of different kinds of genres and it works super well. They supported the game for a couple of years now. They recently released updates for the next gen consoles and it seems now they're releasing a whole version for Nintendo Switch. And I'm telling you, if you have not played Remnant, you definitely should give it a look, check out a trailer. And if it comes to Switch soon, I think it's gonna be a great pickup. Now I'm hoping somebody is assisting the port to make this game perform well. It's not like a crazy looker, but there is a lot going on and you wanna make sure that you have really good performance for the game that requires difficult combat, right? Last second, last ditch efforts with guns and bullets flying and big monsters coming in for the kill. I will say that like, I didn't feel like the gear was all that exciting, the weapons. Maybe they've updated that since I played, but this is a really cool game as you're rolling through different levels, eventually fighting off against big, disastrous bosses and doing it all in a very difficult cooperative fashion. A super fun one, super excited to see it come to Switch. Hopefully we get a date soon and I'll definitely keep you posted. Let me know in the comments if you're excited for this one, if it sounds good, if it looks good, and if you wanna play it on your Nintendo Switch. But the best news on Freaky Friday is that Nintendo is listening, okay? They are doing work on Nintendo Switch Online. And recently they announced that Banjo Kazooie was coming in January. And I was like, okay, giving us a forward progress plan. That's pretty good. One game at a time, but it's a forward progress plan. And now they've done even more, stealth dropping 5 new games onto the service, this time from the Genesis platform. As the expansion pack includes N64 and Genesis, it's good that the latter half is getting love as well. And they're bringing us Altered Beast, Toe Jam and Earl, Dynamite Heady, Sword of Vermillion, and Thunder Force 2 on the Nintendo Switch Online right now. You can play these if you have the expansion pack, and 5 feels a lot better than 1. I wish they'd do 5 with the N64 side of things. And look, I know this is not perfect. Expansion pack still has a ways to go, but they're making progress, all right? We're still in 2021 and they have delivered Paper Mario, an update on Banjo-Kazooie, and 5 Genesis titles. So this is actually going in a good direction. I think we can feel hopeful. I know I've been very critical of Nintendo and their handling of the expansion pack, rightfully so, right? They really didn't deliver an excellent value in any way. And I still hope for themes, I still hope for folders, more DLC, and hopefully Game Boy and Game Boy Advance. But as of right now, it's looking up. Previously it was looking very down, but now your $50 investment is getting regular content. And if they can keep it going this way, a drip feed that happens every month is a lot better than a drip feed that happens twice or 3 times a year, okay? It still may not be the ultimate service, but if Nintendo can keep on this cadence, they're moving towards something that does feel a lot better for our wallets and our minds. Now, in terms of the games themselves, I was not a big Genesis guy. I will say that Toe Jam and Earl absolutely mind-boggled me many, many times. I don't know, something about the game seemed super appealing and super cool to me, especially when I was younger, and I really could never figure it out. I really didn't understand what was going on in that wild world. Do you like this game? It's very, very strange. Altered Beast, you know, very classic, popular title. Dynamite Heady, never played, looks interesting. Sword of Vermillion is an RPG, and then Thunder Force 2 is an arcade-y shooter. Let me know if you wanna pick any of these up, and if you feel like Switch Online is at least moving in the right direction. Since they announced the expansion pack, all right, they said, hey, N64, Genesis, and Animal Crossing DLC, well, we've got Paper Mario and Banjo-Kazooie coming soon, two of the best N64 titles. We have a 5-pack of Genesis games, and now I think the next best thing they can do is announce another freebie. Okay, Animal Crossing DLC is great, but if you don't play ACNH, then you have no use for that. So I think either a free game along the lines of Tetris 99, but just for expansion pack owners would be great. Although since that would severely limit the player count, I think the best thing they can do is offer whatever DLC comes next for free for NSO expansion pack owners. Based on the earlier lineup, there's gonna be a lot of options. Pokemon Legends Arceus, that's a popular title, and that could really help push the expansion pack user base. You say that, hey, whatever big Pokemon Legends Arceus DLC pack is coming to expansion pack? I think that's a really good move. I think that would really feel like they're fertilizing the value proposition of this pack, and it would get a lot of players, like millions of players excited. And hey, they started with Animal Crossing, one of the best-selling games on the entire platform. So it does seem like they're really trying to target a wide, wide swath of people. They're casting a huge net across large demographics, and Pokemon makes a lot of sense. I don't know that there'll be any substantial DLC for Brilliant Diamond and Shining Pearl. That could be an option, but I feel like Pokemon Legends Arceus would be a much more exciting pick and would make that expansion pack feel much more and truly expanded. Love to hear from you though, love to know what you think, and of course, I love to know what you think on the polls every weekday evening. This one, really, really good topic. What year did you buy your Switch? And I think this is just interesting. It shows the growth, the progressive stair-stepping of Nintendo as they dominate the industry in this generation, at least as of now. A lot of you got this in the OG year, myself included. 2017, 35% of the audience is there from the get-go, from the beginning. But everywhere else is pretty even, Steven. 2020 saw 20% of you come on board with this hybrid platform. 2019 and 18 both saw 16% grab their Nintendo Switch goodness. And 2021, 12% of you just hopping on board this year. And with supply constraints and shortages, man, it makes sense. A lot of you have been waiting for your Switch. And now with the amazing catalog, the awesome support, and the continued rollout of really great titles, I mean, next year could be the best year ever. We're here approaching the 6 year of Switch. This is about to be wild and crazy. I'm so glad we get to go on the ride together. You all have a wonderful ride of a weekend. All right, ride that thing. Whether it's up or down, just know you will make it through. The sun will rise tomorrow and things will be okay. I'm sending you lots of love. Make sure to smash that like button if you enjoy these videos. Stay safe, stay healthy, stay happy, stay positive out there. And until next time, my wonderful friends, GMM returns on Monday. For now though, Switch Force out.